Welcome everyone to the Book Marketeers podcast. My name is Big.
My name is Guy.
And my name is Dew.
We are the Book Marketeers.
Today, the novel that we are going to talk about is The Graveyard Book by Neil Gaiman. And this novel is a children's fantasy novel. The story follows the young life of a boy called Nobody Owens, who is orphaned as a toddler. When a man kills his entire family, and Nobody is adopted by ghosts from the local graveyard, and he was raised by the ghost too. And this world is full of vampires, werewolves, mummies, and even ghouls. And he was taught to use a variety of supernatural abilities. The chapter of this novel takes place at 2 years intervals in Nobody's life. So today I think that everyone might already finish this book. So today, this is going to be like a brief discussion after listening this novel. And after we have read this novel, we think that this character, Nobody Owens or Bart, is very interesting. And I think that this character is supposed to be analyzed. Let's get to know who is Bart. Nobody Owens or Bart is a perfectly normal boy. Well, he would be perfectly normal if he didn't live in a graveyard, being raised and educated by ghosts. And there are dangers and adventures for him in the graveyard, such as the strange and terrible menace of the Slea, a gravestone entrance to a desert that leads to the city of ghouls, friendship with a witch, and so much more. And the first analysis that I have gotten from this character, Bart, is that this character, Bart, can represent children or children in Western culture. Because I think that this character, Bart, is raised in the graveyard independently. Because this graveyard is free for him. He can do anything that he wants.
Yes. Of course, the way Bart was brought up and was nurtured can reflect Western culture. We can see in the story that the ghost who take care of Bart, even his step parents, the Owen family, or his guardian Silas, they give Bart an independence to live his life. Bart has independence to go anywhere, do anything that out of the sight of his parents. He goes to the witch grave, he goes to the outside world, or even when he was in the graveyard, many chapters, we can see that Bart do many things alone. This shows that his parents and his guardian are not too protective, so they give Bart freedom and independence to do anything by Bart self since he was young. And this is totally contrast with our culture. I'm sure that all of us have encountered it before. When we were young, we had to do everything on the eyes of our parents. They always kept us on sight, and there were not many chances for us to do something, pay something, or go somewhere alone when we were kids like Bart. So the way Bart was treated by his parents and his guardian can represent Western culture, and I think it is totally converse with the way Thai parents raise their children.
Yes, I think that's a good analysis. And what about you, Dew? Do you have any interesting analysis from this?
Sure. I think another obvious characteristic of Nobody Owens or Bart that is worth mentioning is the fact that he is still young. Not only he has to live in the graveyard and be raised by other ghosts, but also those surrounding him are mostly the elder ghosts. So in chapter 5, we can see that it is the chapter about the traditional dance where the living and the dead come to a kind of ritual and dance together at midnight. Bardozo attends the dance as well, and by seeing the dead and the living mingling together peacefully, after the dance, Bart went to ask the elders' characters about the dance and how happy it was that everybody was dancing together. However, after that, Bart was told by the Josiah Warrington not to talk about the dance. Mm-hmm. How, anyhow, we can see that Bart, who is still young and energetic, is very eager to conjoin and make amends for the incongruence of the two opposite groups of people, in this case, the living and the dead. He wants them to live peacefully together or talk to each other. And when thinking about this situation, it is very similar to the current incident in Thailand. Right now, at the moment of our record, 10 December 2020, there's been a youth demonstration against the abnormality in our society for several months. And most of the demonstrators are the youth. Mm-hmm. And for this reason, I can feel the relation of the story, even from this children's book, to our present society in Thailand. The youth who see that there is something strange and not okay happening in the society do not just turn the blind eyes on the problems. They are like the middlemen who want to voice their will that they disagree. Like Bart, his gray suit, the color between black and white, reinforces his youth as being a middleman. And the time of the dance at midnight also suggests so. It is a time where the night ends and the morning begins. So that is the second characteristic that I think is very interesting.
Yeah, yes. Absolutely.
And I have another point that I would like to talk is about the other. The other always tell his leader that Bart is a person that always help other people.
Yes.
And what do you think about this? Why the other need to do like this?
First, I think that it is a completely superb idea that the book include moral, and I would say that is an indirect suggestion to the children or young readers that when we see something wrong in the society or see the weak one is threatened, we have to stand and do like Bart does. For example, Bart helps Lisa, the witch, to find her gravestone, and he also helps the kids who are bullied at school. This is show that Bart is like a savior. He is helpful and he is also willing to help others. So this is what the story try to present and try to encourage young readers. When you see something wrong or see someone that need a help, you could not just ignore them, but you have to give them a hand.
Yes, what do you think about it?
Mm-hmm. I think when we read a children's book, we can take just only the literal entertainment that the book portrays, like the fantasy, the adventures, and the fight, something like that. But what the author, Neil Gaiman, tries to do, underlying that literal, superficial layer of the book, is he portrays our protagonist as someone who is a savior who wants to help others, and I think it's a very superb idea, like you said. And this correlates with the previous point that I made as well, that we should not turn the blind eyes on the problems and something that is not right in the society.
Yes, I think so. And
so I think this is the brief overview of the book, The Graveyard, and I think for those who wants to take some time off and escape from the busy and annoying and boring world, you can try out this book. It's worth your time, and you are gonna be on the beautiful journey in the graveyard, and it's going to be beyond your expectation. So that is all for our podcast today. stay tuned for our next episode. We are the Book Musketeers.